Welcome to Science Storms at the Museum of Science and Industry. I'm Dr. Olivia Castellini, Senior Exhibit Developer here at the museum. Science Storms was created to explore the amazing science behind natural phenomena. So here in the exhibit, you'll find awe-inspiring, large-scale recreations of seven different natural phenomena, including avalanches and tornadoes. So I want to give you a sneak peek on how these things were made. So when you come in, we want to take a look at these giant phenomena and then use those as an entryway to talk about different aspects of science. So come with me and we'll take a deep dive into how these amazing exhibits came to be. This is the Avalanche Disc. The avalanche area of Science Storms introduces us to ideas about forces and motion. So here in the Avalanche Disc, we can see a couple different forces demonstrated. We have the force of gravity, which pulls the sand down the front of the disc. And then we have the force of friction that opposes that motion as that sand slides. The rotation of the disc introduces centripetal forces. So all of those forces combine to determine how the sand moves and the beautiful patterns that we see. The sand inside of there is actually two different kinds of sand. So the white material is actually really tiny glass beads, and the brown material is garnet sand. So the mixture of those two things creates a really interesting look, but the sand itself, those two are slightly different sizes, and so that's going to change the frictional force that acts on the garnet or the glass. So as gravity pulls that sand down, the friction opposes it. And because the force is a little bit different with each of those materials, you see these patterns emerge as the glass and the garnet are slowed at different rates. So this is a great demonstration of basic forces that change how objects move. Another interesting bit of science is the idea of liquids and solids. So granular materials, sand is one of them, they can behave like a liquid or a solid. So this is unlike things like water. So if you freeze it, it becomes a solid, it becomes ice. But if you heat it up and you change the temperature, it will actually go through what's called a phase change and it'll become a liquid. Granular materials like sand don't need a temperature change to change between acting like a solid and acting like a liquid. So we can explore that using the disc. So as it's moving, you see it flowing like a liquid. It's coming and pulling down the side. But if I slow the disc down, you see as it slowly starts to lose speed, it starts to pack over on the side as all of the sand gets pulled down and starts to pile up over on the other side. So it's acting like a liquid as gravity pulls it down and it flows, but as it stops, the sand starts to pack over on the side and act like a solid. Not only can we look at basic forces with the avalanche disc, we can also explore liquid and solid behaviors using granular materials. The front of the avalanche disc is beautiful, but one of my favorite parts is actually the backside of the disc where all of the gears and the motors are. So the avalanche disc, again, huge engineering challenge. And one of the first things that you may notice is that it's not actually sitting on the exhibit floor. We have a raised flooring here in Science Storms, and because all of the electrical and data all go underneath our feet, so we had to raise the floor up and then put the exhibits on top of that so we could run power to them. Now the avalanche disc posed a problem because it's so heavy. So you'll notice the beautiful blue glow around the inside, that's actually creating a little mask so that we could sit the avalanche on the actual building floor instead of on the raised floor. The feet coming out are to distribute the load so that it distributes that weight a little bit so that the floor can actually hold the exhibit. The other thing is there is a giant motor. Now the steel disc is incredibly heavy, so it needed a big motor and a giant gear to be able to drive that. The avalanche disc actually will never come to a complete stop. So you can speed it up and slow it down, but because that motor is trying to move such a heavy load, it will actually slow that motor down just enough so it will show the effect, but never comes to a complete stop so that it doesn't give too much wear and tear on that motor from completely stopping and starting over and over again. Now, when we moved the exhibit in, we had to build it here on site and then pour that super smooth coating. So we had to be able to lay the disc flat, level it off so that we could pour that coating, but we needed it then to tilt to be at an angle so that we could run the exhibit and show the effect we wanted to. So this entire thing is on a pivot so we can tilt the avalanche disc to get it all the way flat and then sort of tune it and figure out what the perfect angle to demonstrate the effect is. We don't do it very often because it's quite difficult to do because it is so heavy, but it's kind of fun to look at the gears and understand all of the extra engineering that went into it.